We're in Psalm 30 today, another psalm of Christ. I will extol you, O Lord, for you have lifted me up and have not let my enemies rejoice over me. We've seen this theme very often throughout the book of Psalms, of Christ triumphing over his enemies. We see this in the book of Colossians, where it specifically says that he triumphed over principalities and powers and made a public display of them. And that was through his cross and resurrection. That was his triumph. And we will see in this particular chapter that resurrection is the hope of Christ as he was anticipating victory over his enemies. And it is through his resurrection that he triumphed over his enemies. For it was through his resurrection that he achieved the glory that he had with the Father before the foundation of the world. John 17 says this. O Lord my God, I cried to you for help, and you did heal me. That's his resurrection. You have brought, O Lord, you have brought up my soul from Sheol. We read in the Psalms and in the book of Acts, you will not leave his soul in hell, nor suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have kept me alive that I should not go down to the pit. Sing praise to the Lord, you his godly ones. In other words, as a response to the triumph, the victory of Christ over death, we sing praise. For we do not go down to the dust, to the pit. We give thanks to his holy name, for his anger is but for a moment. And that is what we see at the cross, is the Father's anger poured out on Christ, but for a moment. But his favor is for a lifetime. Weeping may last for a night. Surely he has borne our sorrows. And it lasted for a night. But a shout of joy comes in the morning. That's the morning of his resurrection. Remember, these psalms are about Christ. Luke 24, verse 27 and 44. Now as for me, I said in my prosperity, I will never be moved. O Lord, by your favor, you have made my mountain to stand strong. Isn't that interesting? You have made my mountain to stand strong. The Bible says we have come to Mount Zion. And of course, because Mount Zion is the church we see throughout the scriptures, it is built upon the rock of Christ. Therefore, Mount Zion stands strong. So he says, O Lord, by your favor, you have made my mountain to stand strong. And I believe what Christ is saying is, that's my church. Upon this rock will I build my church, Christ says. You did hide your face. I was dismayed. So remember, under the Old Testament, God hid his face from his people, but upon the cross, God has hid his face from his only begotten Son. You did hide your face. I was dismayed. To you, O Lord, I called, and to the Lord I made supplication. What profit is there in my blood? Now think about this. What profit is there in my blood if I go down to the pit? Will the dust praise you? Will it declare your faithfulness? In other words, there would be no profit in the blood of Christ if Christ were to have stayed dead. But because of his resurrection, we are justified by his blood, Romans says in chapter 5. Will the dust praise you? Will it declare your faithfulness? There is no praise of God. There is no profit in the death of Christ unless he rose from the dead. Hear me, O Lord, and be gracious to me. O Lord, be my helper. You have turned for me my mourning into dancing. Christ, you know, we see he has turned their mourning into gladness in Isaiah 61. He's given them beauty for ashes. And so it's through Christ's mourning that we have been given praise and gladness. And it is through Christ's ashes that we have been given beauty. And the Bible says it is through Christ becoming sin, 2 Corinthians 5:21, that we have become righteous. You have loosed my sackcloth and girded me with gladness. That is, God the Father clothed Christ with gladness. And because we're in Christ, we are now clothed with Christ's righteousness and gladness, that my soul may sing praise to you and not be silent. O Lord, my God, I will give thanks to you forever. Have a great Sunday.